Hey guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. Today's video, I'm going to be starting a new series where I'm giving a Pygame tutorial. So pretty much what Pygame is it is a module. It is a third-party module that you can download from the internet that is used to make games using Python. It's pretty simple games. Most of them are 2D, and you can draw shapes and images, and you can go pretty far with Pygame if you know how to use it proficiently. So I'm just going to be doing a beginner's tutorial here, just showing you some of the basics. And in today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing basic movement of a square or a rectangle moving around the screen. And then in the next tutorials, we'll move on to images and sounds and all of that fun stuff. So if you guys want to see the rest of the videos, leave a thumbs up on this video, and I'll be sure to release them later on. Okay, so let's get right into the tutorial. So the first thing we're going to need to do if we're going to be using Pygame is, well, we need to install and download Pygame. So if you haven't done so already, I have a video on my channel. Go check that out. I'll leave a link in the top right corner here. It's going to be a card and one in the description. It's really easy. Just go to watch that video. It's like 2 minutes, 3 minutes long, and get that done before you do that. Okay, so if you've done that, now what we need to do is we need to import that module. So import Pygame like that. If this doesn't work for you for some reason, you get an error when you run your program, go watch the video again and redo it, because everything should work if you have it installed properly. Alright, the next thing we need to do is we need to initialize our Pygame. So that can be done by simply typing pygame.init. You always need to do that at the beginning of your program so you don't forget and get that error. Alright, so now we need to create a window. This window is going to be what we draw on. So to do so, you're going to make a variable. In this case, I'm going to call it win. I'm going to set it equal to display, pygame.display.set underscore mode. Now inside of these brackets here, we're putting a tuple, or a tuple, however you like to call it. And this is going to be the width and the height of our window. So in this case, I'm going to do 500 by 500. Feel free to set this to whatever you want. Alright, now we're going to give our window a caption. So if I just run the program right now, you can see that we get a Pygame window, which is pretty boring. We want to give our program a proper name. So to do that, all we have to do is pygame.display.set underscore caption, like so. And then in there, we can just type whatever we want our caption to be. In this case, I'm just going to type and set mine to first game, like that. Now, once we do that, if we run the program like so, we should see that up here it says first game. There you go. All right. Now, the next steps. Well, we want to make a character move on the screen. So, there's a few things we need to do before we can actually start drawing the character and moving the character. Our character is going to have a few attributes to it. So, it's going to have a width, a height, an X and a Y position, and then it's also going to have a velocity, meaning how fast it moves. So, we need to start by setting that up right now. So, we're just going to set X equal to 50, Y equal to 50. You can change these numbers to whatever you like as long as they fit inside of your screen so you see your character. I'm going to set the width equal to, let's do 40, and the height to 60, just like so. So we get a rectangle instead of a square, and then we're going to do velocity, which is how fast our character moves, and we'll set this to 5. Alright, so now that we've done that, we need to start writing our main loop. So all Pygame programs pretty much have a main loop, and in this main loop, this is what's going to check for collision, it's going to check for mouse events, it's going to check if you hit something. So you're always going to want to make a main loop. There's different ways that you can do it. This is one of the simpler ways. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to use a while loop. By the way, I forgot to mention this. If you don't know Python, I do have Python tutorials on my channel that you can go check out. You might want to check those out before you watch this video, as I'm not really going to explain what I'm doing in this video in terms of basic programming, because I already have videos explaining that before. So I'm kind of assuming you know a little bit about Python or about programming in general. So yeah, that is kind of a prerequisite for this video. Sorry, I should have mentioned that at the beginning. Okay, so we're going to start now by just making a run variable. And then we're going to do while run. And then in here, this is going to be our main loop. So we're going to check for collision. We're going to check for everything in here. So now I'm going to start by just giving my loop a time delay. So this is just so things don't happen super quick. And this is kind of like the clock in your game. So you can't actually make a clock in Pygame, but this is the easier way to do it. So this is what I'm going to do for this tutorial. Pretty much this parameter here is just gonna it's just milliseconds, so it's gonna be 0.1 seconds here with 100 milliseconds. You do 1,000, that'll be a full second, which is a little bit too much time in my opinion. Okay, now we're gonna start by checking for events. So an event in Pygame is anything that happens from the user. So pretty much if I move my mouse, if I click anything on the keyboard, those are what the events would be. So to check for the events, we need to make a for loop. So for event in Pygame dot event dot get, just like that. And that's going to get a list of all of the events that happen. So me moving my mouse here would say mouse position moved here, keyboard press here. And then we can loop through all of those events and check if they have happened. And if they have happened, then we can do the following, right? So we can do whatever is in that code. So in this case, I'm just going to check if we click the exit button on our window. So if event.type equals equals pygame.quit. So if you hit the big red button in the corner, then what we need to do is we just need to break the loop actually. So run equals false. And then at the bottom of our loop, we can do pygame.quit, which pretty much just ends the program and closes the window for us. All right, so we can go ahead and check if this works. We're going to click F5, enter. And then we have our first game right here. If I click the X button, it closes and we don't get an error in our thing, which is good to see. All right, so now for the next steps and drawing the character. So we're going to draw our character right now, which is just going to be a rectangle. Pretty boring, I know. And we're not going to get till moving it until the next step. So what we want to do here is we want to draw a rectangle, which is going to represent our character. So to do this is pretty simple. We're going to do pygame.draw.rect. Now, if you want to draw a circle, it would be .circle, polygon, .polygon. You can look on the Pygame website for all the different shapes that you can do, and it'll give you all of the parameters that you need to type in. Now, the first parameter that all of these are going to take is going to be the window or the surface that we are drawing this onto. Everything in Pygame is a surface, so when we make this rectangle, it's going to create a surface, which is going to be put onto the window surface. So window is the first one, the Pygame surface. The next one is going to be the color. So all the colors in Pygame are RGB. So in this case, I want to make mine red. So red, green, blue would be like that. 255 red. So we get it red. And then it takes a rect. So a rect is an X, Y, width, and height. And how perfect. We already have these defined from above. So you can do X, Y, width, height. Like so. And now I just want to show you what actually happens if I run this program. You can see our character doesn't show up on the screen. Now, why is that the case? Well, if we want something to show up in Pygame or we want to refresh the display, we have to do so. To do that, we have to do pygame.display.update. And now, if we run our program, should see we get a red rectangle at 50-50 with a width of 40 and a height of 60. There we go. Now, we want to move that rectangle. So how can we do that? Now, there's a few ways we can do that. The first way that we can do that is by simply using the same event thing right here. We can see if a key has been pressed, and if it's been pressed, we can simply change the X and Y of our character to move it right or to move it left. But the reason that's not good is because if I simply click on the right arrow key and I hold down the right arrow key, it's only going to move my character one time. It's not going to continue to move my character like you would want. So we want to do, if you're holding down the key, continue to move the character in whatever direction that would be. And this is the way that I'm going to show you. So what we need to do is we actually need to set up a list. So I'm just going to call mine keys, not in capitals, lowercase. Keys is equal to pygame.keys.get_press. And I believe that's what it is. Actually, I think it is key. So we'll do key like that. Yeah, that should be the right one. And now if we want to check what key has been pressed, we can simply do a little if statement. So we do if keys and then pygame.key dot, I think is what it is. One second, let's just check. Oops, pygame.k_left. So that'd be for the left arrow key. And then the next one would be if keys and then pygame.k_right. And then if keys, same thing again, we're going to do the up arrow key and then the down arrow key. So .k_up. And if keys, pygame.k_down, like so. So now we have our four keys. And if those are pressed or they are held down, then we're going to do whatever we put inside of these if statements. So in this case, we just want to move our character by the velocity in whatever direction. So I'll show you the way the grid works in Pygame once I load it up, but pretty much it doesn't work as your standard 0, 0, negative, positive grid. It's actually not from the middle of the screen, it's from the top left of the screen. So up here where my mouse is, if you can see it at the top left, it would be 0, 0. That's where my mouse is, 0, 0. If you go all the way down here, it would be 500, 500. If you're up here, it would be 500, 0, just like that. So the coordinates are from the top left, and as you go right, that adds to the x coordinate, and as you go down, that adds to the y coordinate. So down here, where it would usually be a negative, negative number, it's actually a positive, and then y, 0, and then a positive for the y coordinate, and I'll show you that as that works. So if we want to move left, we just have to subtract from the x-coordinate. So say we're over here and we want to move left, we just have to simply subtract from our x-coordinate. You can do that by doing x minus equals vel. And the vel is just so we can change the speed by simply changing one variable rather than changing four numbers in our line of code here. If we want to move right, well, we need to add. So we're going to add to our vel, or to our x-coordinate, sorry. If we want to move up, well, we need to subtract from our y-coordinate. So we're going to subtract the vel from our y-coordinate, and then if we want to move down, we need to add to our y-coordinate, like so. Now I'm just going to add one thing in here, because you'll see what happens. Actually, we can run it first just to see what happens. When I try moving to the right, you can see it actually just creates a big mass of rectangles, and that's because we're just constantly drawing a new rectangle. We're not actually drawing over top of the old rectangles. So what we need to do here is we actually need to fill the screen before we draw this new rectangle. So to do that, you can simply do win.fill and then a color inside of here. So in this case, I'm just going to do black so it matches with our background color, 0, 0, 0, just like that. And now you can see, as I move the mouse and hold down the keys, our little character, our little square, is actually moving around the screen. Now you will notice, though, that it can go off the screen if I eventually get to the right here. It'll just keep going. So if you want to see how to fix that, it's pretty simple. You can maybe try to figure it out yourself if you know a little bit about Python. It just has to do with checking the x and the y values. I'll do that in another tutorial. So that's been it for this first tutorial, guys. All we've really covered is how to draw a rectangle and how to move it around the screen using key presses. In the next tutorial, I think I'm going to talk about, well, constraining this so that you can't move outside of the box, maybe adding some jumping code and some other images and blitting those to the screen. So if you guys did like the video and you want to see another one, please leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you again in the next video.